to twist or not to twist? That seems to be the question. All right, so there is this debate you're gonna find in little forums and little social media environments where people are like, why do you pre-twist? It's a waste of time. And they're like, why don't you pre-twist? It's a solid joint. Like, why is there even any argument about that? And I've been in and out of this conversation for years, and people always ask me, do you twist? Do you pre-twist before you put a wire nut on? Or do you just take the two conductors, put them together, and put the wire nut on? So where this comes from, wire nuts used to not be constructed internally the same way that they are now. So they're actually listed, most of them are listed, so that when they twist, they actually twist the wires together. So a lot of times I've gone out to plenty of service calls in the past where I've had like a couple of recessed cans not working in a room, or I've had just little tiny things that would go wrong that would cut power to like the remaining portion of a circuit. The problem with the materials is a lot of them weren't making a good enough connection over a long period of time. And so it, you know, as things heat up and cool, metal expands. And so some things can lose their strength, lose their connection. In a receptacle, if you're plugging in and unplugging constantly, you're just shaking, you know, every time you use it, you're just like moving things a little bit. So the conductors can end up moving free. And so a lot of times you'll have one receptacle that, you know, each receptacle is daisy chained. And if the incoming power becomes loose, or the outgoing, you know, conductor to the next one becomes loose, it won't make the connection to continue on to the rest of the circuit. So there's enough things like that that I have been in through my career that I'm just like, nah, dude, solid joints on everything. Like, I don't want anything being dependent on a device. So if the device fails, the rest of the circuit also fails. This is why most of the time you'll see people, I do it every time in commercial, you have to put, you know, all of your incoming conductors into a joint and then run a pigtail to the device. That way, if the device fails itself and you have to replace the device or whatever, the rest of the circuit is still intact. And so that whole like floor of people working on computers doesn't just lose power because this one receptacle went bad, right? So that doesn't necessarily mean twist or pre-twist either way. I am of the opinion, my way of doing things is that I like to pre-twist, but I do understand the argument that you don't always need to pre-twist. So let's look at some examples of solid conductors and stranded conductors and just show the twisting. All right, so we got this situation, right? We got some solid conductors. Let's do a test here. Twisting, not twisting. I'm gonna just use my Klein's to strip. I do that pretty often if I don't have said strippers on me, which I don't currently have said strippers on me. All right, so to twist or not to twist. I always twist. I like this because when I take a wire nut off, you know, have conductors all the way in the back of the box and I take the wire nuts off, these things don't come apart. Like, this is a solid joint. There's not going anywhere. And when the wire nut's on, you're like moving things around, this isn't gonna come loose at all. I can't tell you how many situations I've gone to in recessed cans or whatever, things just don't work, and you go and you sit and tug on these and one of the conductors falls out. That is why I choose to pre-twist. Now, the argument for not pre-twisting is that most wire nuts today are set up so that you don't have to twist. The way that the inside of this is shaped, you can put these up to each other, put them on, and it's still gonna hold. Like, that's not coming out of there. So really, the people that are saying that you don't need to pre-twist, they're right also, because the wire nuts are designed to twist. So let's take this off and see what this looks like. Boom, it twisted. Now, it's not a good twist, you know, like I could pull these things apart. So it's just my opinion that you should actually pre-twist. Now, what about stranded conductors? Don't pay attention to the fact that I've just got this floppy pipe here. This is in my studio, so I'm just being stupid. Now, when you have stranded conductors, when you put them together with a wire nut without twisting, they actually do a lot better job, right? I tend to cross them over each other. And then if you're gonna put this thing on, it's going to twist a lot more once you take this off. Look at that, nice and twisted. So for stranded, you don't really have to worry about it so much. Like, that's still not gonna come apart. But for me, I'm still gonna be super extra about it just because I want to. I always make sure when I put my stranded conductors together that I twist them anyways. It's a much more solid connection. Again, just a preference thing, but I like to do that. I know for sure those are not coming apart no matter what. That's a solid joint. Now, where the people that say that the pre-twist is not necessary, they do have a point. There's a lot of times where we use listed pressure connectors. So this is just something that you would stab in. So a lot of times in ballasts, we'll have something like this where the conductor just slides into place. The other side slides into place. And then boom, like this is still solid. These are not gonna come out of there. It's just a small thin piece of metal that's holding it on. But if this is good enough, and we use these all the time, these are not twisted together, right? They're just touching each other. So when we connect this, everything's connected. When we take it out, it breaks the circuit. So in this case, like we're not twisting a joint together. So it just goes to show it's just a preference thing. If you like to pre-twist, go ahead and pre-twist. If you don't like to pre-twist, don't pre-twist. Either way, it's just a preference, but you know, you do need to make a good connection. So you don't want anything to be loose on any connection that you make.
So what does the National Electrical Code say about this? Code doesn't actually say much, doesn't say that you have to do anything a certain way because they leave that up to the manufacturer listing, and you're always supposed to install things according to manufacturer's listings. So if we look in 110, it's kind of the general provisions for how to deal with conductors and equipment. We look in 110.14b under splices. It says conductors shall be spliced or joined with splicing devices identified for the use or by brazing, welding, or soldering with a fusible metal or alloy. All splices and joints and the free ends of conductors shall be covered with an insulation equivalent to that of the conductors or with an identified insulating device. So that's really all it gives you for splicing. And when you're putting a wire connector on, you are essentially, even though you're like twisting something, you're splicing those things together. You're making a connection. So it's just saying that we need to use whatever according to its listing. If you have wire connectors that say that you need to twist them together, you need to twist them together. If they say that you need to stack them together, you need to stack them together. But that's really all it gives you. So this is one of those silly things like, should you be wearing tool belts or should you be carrying a bag, where there's not actually a right or wrong answer. It's just largely preferential. I can say that I've never had a situation where I've had people pre-twist joints where I've had to go back and fix anything, you know, just solid. One thing a lot of people don't like though is they don't like having to untwist a whole bunch of conductors, and then you got these gnarled up curly things and you got to sit and straighten every one of them out. So it can be a pain in the butt for people that have to work on twisted joints after the fact. Completely understand that. But either way, if you're putting two conductors together, they're still twisting together. They're just not twisting together as well. So that's just more of a cop-out, like laziness problem to deal with. Don't ever just have two straight conductors and barely put a wire nut on so that when you pull it off, they pop off at you. You need some kind of a twist on them because that's a solid joint. The other thing I've run into is people put like four or five conductors together, and instead of, you know, stripping out a little bit more and making sure that they're all put together and that they lay down really nicely as one solid joint, they just stick a wire nut on that and push it in the back of the box. I mean, you take the wire nut off, everything goes poof out in your face, and that sucks. That's not good work. That's not quality craftsmanship. So here's what I have to say about it. Always do work to the best of your ability. Always try to impress yourself every single day, everything that you touch. Be a craftsman. Take this stuff seriously. This can really hurt or kill people, so you need to take what you do with deadly seriousness. And I think, in my opinion, and how I teach my people, I, being the one taking the liability, owning the company, I want all my people pre-twisting. I just do. I think it's a better method. That's my opinion. Whatever it's worth, do whatever you're gonna do. But if you walk away from something and be like, that's kind of ass, but then you just walk away anyways, that's a whole different thing. That's just laziness, and you need to get over that. If you can walk away from everything and be like, that's solid, like that looks great, it functions great, I know that there's not gonna be any service calls because of this, I'm great covering that up, I think that's the way to do it. And in my book, pre-twists, that's the way that I feel the most safe and the most solid about all of my installs. And I've just had way fewer service calls doing things that way. So anyways, let me know your opinions. I can tell you're already in the comments. I can tell already.
get those fingers ready. Make sure you do some exercises, like get the fancy fingers going. You know, I need you to type like a lot of hate under this. Please, please give me your opinions. I need your approval so badly. I love you crazy people. I'll see you in the next one.